This video is a compilation of 4 different basic and easy types of cake. Let's get started. In a kadhai, add 1/2 cup salt. The color looks different because I have been reusing this salt in baking. Cover it and preheat at medium flame for 15 minutes. And you can preheat your normal convection or OTC at 180 degrees Celsius. While our kadhai is preheating, take milk. So this is 200 ml full fat milk. It should be warm or gunguna. To this, add 1.5 teaspoon vinegar or sirka. Mix the milk and the vinegar well, and after that you need to let this rest for 10 to 15 minutes. After that, we're going to add some cooking oil. So this is 3 tablespoon cooking oil. You can use refined oil or any flavorless oil. And now add 1 teaspoon vanilla essence, or you can also use vanilla extract. Mix everything well. Now add 1 cup powdered sugar. So this is our regular sugar which we have in our homes. Just grind it using mixer grinder and then you'll get the powder. Now add 1 cup semolina and suji or rava, the fine one, barik wali. Then add 6 tablespoon cocoa powder. I'm using Dutch processed. 3/4 teaspoon baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, and then mix everything well. If you people would like to know the products I use or the similar products, you can check out the link given in this video's description box. The link is to Amazon. So I'm using 5-inch cake tin for this. It's lined with butter paper. You can also use 6 or 6.5-inch cake tin for this amount of batter. Pour in the mixture, and after pouring in, let it sit because it will thicken a bit because the suji will absorb all the liquids. So after letting it sit for 15 minutes, put some grated dry fruits on top of it, like almonds, pistachios. So our kadhai oven has been preheating. It's been 15 minutes. I'm going to place this mold inside, and first 15 minutes I'm going to bake this cake at medium flame, and after that I'm going to lower the flame. So it normally takes 1 hour for this cake to bake because I've used 5-inch cake tin, but if you use 6 or 6.5-inch cake tin, this might be done in 45 to 50 minutes. But if it's not done, you can again cover and cook the cake till it's done. So you can see it's completely done. I'm going to cover and let it cool down, or at least become warm, so that I can demold it. So after the cake becomes warm or it cools down, you're going to demold it. So the cake has turned out really well, nice, porous, spongy. You can see the texture, it looks really amazing. It's nice and moist. I'll cut and show you a piece of it. Looks lovely. Give this recipe a try and let me know in the comment section. Enjoy! So this is a pressure cooker, an old pressure cooker, and I've lined this with some salt. You can see the color of the salt is not white because this is the same salt which I'm reusing from my pizza recipe. Now place a stand on this. The mold I'm going to use has a removable bottom, that's why I'm going to place a plate on it. If you're using a normal mold, directly place it on the stand. Place the pressure cooker's lid and do not forget to remove the whistle. It's very important. Now preheat this pressure cooker between low to medium flame for 10 minutes. Preheating is very important. Meanwhile, this pressure cooker oven gets preheated. Let's prepare the cake batter. In a bowl, take 1/4 cup of unsalted butter at room temperature. Make sure you scrape out all the butter. Now using a whisk, beat this for a minute. So after beating the butter for a minute, add the icing sugar. I'm using 3/4 cup plus 1 tablespoon. I suggest that you use icing sugar only, but if you do not have icing sugar, you can use regular powdered sugar as well, but it should be finely powdered. Now give this a good mix and beat for 2 to 3 minutes till this becomes very light and fluffy.
you will see the butter and sugar will not come together easily, but as soon as you keep beating it, it will. So you can see it's been 2 to 3 minutes and this has become very light. Look at it. Even the color has become lighter. Now in a bowl, take half cup of milk powder. Add 1 cup of warm milk. The milk should be warm and not hot. We are using warm milk because the milk powder doesn't get dissolved in cold milk easily. The milk should be warm and not hot. You need to take care of that. Now add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and mix it well. Now add this liquid to the butter sugar mix. Gently mix this, we don't want to overbeat it here. Okay, you can see a little bit of butter floating at the top, that's fine. Do not overbeat and don't try to mix it. This is absolutely fine. Now we are going to add the dry ingredients. Add 1 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour or maida. 1/4 cup of corn flour, also called as cornstarch. 1 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. Sift all this well. Now gently fold the dry ingredients into the wet mix. I'm showing this in fast forward, but I'm actually doing it very slowly. So you need to be gentle with this. Just before baking, add 1 teaspoon of vinegar and lightly fold using a spatula into the batter. I've made my cake mold ready. I've lined it with butter paper from all the sides. No need to grease and dust with maida, just line with butter paper. I highly recommend the use of butter paper or parchment paper to line the mold. Also, before you make your batter, you need to keep your mold ready. Now tap the mold like this to remove any air bubble, and now we are going to bake this cake in our homemade pressure cooker oven. Remove the pressure cooker's lid and place the cake mold gently. Be careful while placing this because the pressure cooker is hot. Now place the lid on. Now comes the most crucial part, that is the baking. Follow my instructions carefully. We are going to bake this cake for around 50 to 55 minutes. For first 30 minutes, you need to keep the flame between low to medium, not low. And then for the remaining time, you need to keep the flame on low. So it's been total of 55 minutes. You can see the cake has very uniformly risen. You don't see a big dome at the center. This is a sign that you have got a very good cake. And yes, one more thing, if you see, we had filled the mold halfway and you can see how much this has risen. Also, it springs back when I press it. I'll put a skewer inside. You can see it has come out clean. I took out the mold from the cooker and placed it on a wire rack. If you do not have a wire rack, you can place it on any elevated stand. Cover this with a cloth and let it cool completely. So the cake has cooled down completely. Now we'll run a knife along the edges of the cake. We have used butter paper, so we don't really need to do this, but it will help us demold the cake better. So I'm going to place a glass. You can place a glass or a bowl and push the sides of mold like this. But if your mold is not this kind, you can flip the cake on a plate and then demold it by tapping. I'll show you the bottom of the cake. Look at this beautiful cake. See how it's springing back? Remove the butter paper from the sides as well. You can see the sides have perfectly browned. These are not overdone. These are not burnt and are spongy as well. Our beautifully gorgeous cake is ready to be served. Enjoy!
So first you need to preheat your kadhai or cooker, so for that add 1/2 cup cooking salt, and this salt can be reused multiple times for baking. And place a stand and a plate, or you can only place the stand. and we're going to cover it and preheat at medium flame for 15 minutes. If you're going to do this in electric oven, you need to preheat your oven at 180 degrees Celsius. Now let's prepare our batter. So for that, I'm taking two 120 gram each Oreo biscuits packet. So one packet is 120 gram and we are using two such packets, so total 240 gram. And I'm taking the biscuits or the Oreo cookies along with its cream. The cream will make the batter sweet and it's just perfectly sweet. You don't need to add any additional sugar. So the ingredients are just going to be milk, Oreo and baking powder. So here I've ground all the Oreo cookies into fine powder. Now to this I'm adding milk. This milk is at room temperature. Total half cup is what we're going to need to make the batter. So add all the milk and mix everything well so there are no lumps in the batter. And here I've prepared my cake tin. I've lined it with butter paper. If you want, you can just use some oil and maida or all-purpose flour. And then at the end, add 1 teaspoon baking powder and mix it well. I mean, mix the batter well and immediately pour it into the mold. And just 2-3 more Oreo cookies. I'm just breaking them into pieces and putting them on the top of the cake. This is optional. It makes the cake look good. And yes, the ingredients still remain 3. That is Oreo, baking powder and milk. Now this will go inside our preheated kadhai oven and we're going to bake this at medium flame for first 10 minutes and then 10 to 15 minutes on low flame in an electric oven, as I said, 180 degrees Celsius preheating, and then baking this cake for 20 to 25 minutes will work. And after this cake is done, I mean after the time has elapsed, we can check by inserting a toothpick. So this, let's check whether this is done or not. This cake is quite hot and you can see the skewer has come out clean. So our cake is done. I'm going to take it out, cover it with a cloth and then let it cool down. And you can see how nice and soft this cake has turned out. Let's cover it and let it cool down or at least become warm. Now let's demold the cake. So this is that kind of mold which has a removable base like this. And look at the beautiful cake. It has risen well. It's very soft. And yes, we just used Oreo biscuits, baking powder and milk. Now I'll cut a piece and show you. Nice and soft and very moist. So it's a very easy recipe. Only 3 ingredients. Follow the recipe well. Add baking powder at the end and make sure you do not overbake, because if you overbake the cake, it will become hard. So give this recipe a try and enjoy. Take a bowl. In that, put 1/2 cup all-purpose flour or maida, a pinch of salt. Now add 1/4 teaspoon baking powder, 1/8 teaspoon baking soda. So to measure 1/8, you can take half of your 1/4 teaspoon measure. So mix everything well and keep this aside. Now we are going to separate the yolk and the egg white of 3 eggs, and we want to use a room temperature eggs because it will take more time to whip the cold eggs and the result would not be that great. So use room temperature eggs. So here I've taken only the yolks. And to this I'm going to add 3/4 cup sugar. So I'm going to use half of this 3/4 cup sugar in the yolks and the remaining half in the egg whites. So this is our regular sugar, just used my mixer grinder to powder it. After adding the sugar, you need to whip everything well. You would notice that in some time the color of the yolks would change and it would become quite white, not very white but very pale in color. So this is just perfect. This is the ribbon consistency. And now to the yolks, I'm going to add 2 teaspoon cooking oil. You can use any cooking oil. and 3 teaspoon vanilla essence or extract. And after this, we're going to use a spatula. So very gently you need to fold everything, because we have incorporated a lot of air in the yolk and the sugar mixture. We don't want to deflate it. Now add 2 tablespoon milk. It should be at room temperature. Again, gently fold everything. Now you're going to add the maida mixture which we prepared at the beginning. Add a very little at a time so that there are no lumps and you would not deflate the batter. So be gentle and mix everything slowly. So this is perfect. Keep it aside. Let's move to the egg whites. While whipping the egg whites, your utensil as well as the attachments should be very clean, otherwise you would not be able to whip the egg whites well. Also, there should not be any trace of egg yolk in the whites. After whipping the egg whites till they become foamy, you need to add vinegar or lemon juice. So this is going to stabilize the egg whites. So these are very important. And after that, keep adding the remaining sugar. Add a spoon or two at a time, whip. Then again, add a little more sugar and whip. So this is how you should be adding the sugar gradually. And then whip the egg whites till you get stiff peaks. So the egg whites are now ready. Do not over whip. So I've lined my cake tin or the cake tray with butter paper, and I've cut the sides of the butter paper like this. So you need to have a flat tray or something like that to bake the base of the Swiss roll. You don't need to apply any oil or butter to the butter paper. So our egg whites are ready and the egg yolks are also ready. Now we're going to gently fold the whites in the egg yolk mixture slowly. So take a little portion of the egg whites, gently fold in the egg yolk mixture, and then again take more whites and repeat this process till the end. Do not use your hand whisk or your electric beater. This step should be carried out very slowly and gently. So our fluffy mixture of the Swiss roll base is ready. I'm going to pour this in our cake tin, which is already ready and lined with the butter paper. Spread the mixture evenly. I have already preheated my oven at 170 degrees Celsius and I'm going to bake this for 15 to 20 minutes. If you have a small mold, if you do not have oven, you can also use normal cake mold, but the size of your Swiss roll would be very small. You can bake this in kadhai or pressure cooker, also similar to the way I do in my other recipes. Okay, so this is out of the oven after 20 minutes and it has cooked perfectly. Now after it becomes warm, so I'm going to cover it now and then we'll carry out the next steps when the cake becomes warm. So once it becomes warm, that is, it's not completely cool, you need to take it out of the mold and using the butter paper itself, roll it. Because it's warm right now, it would be easier to roll. If you let it cool down completely, it might crack while rolling. So that is the reason we are doing it while the cake is warm. And meanwhile it completely cools down, let's prepare the mixed fruit jam. So I've taken 4 to 5 tablespoons of mixed fruit jam and mixed everything well. That's it. And after the cake becomes or cools down, you need to spread the jam evenly all over. And the next step is desiccated coconut or nariyal ka bura. So add this as much as you like as per your taste. Just leave some spaces in between so that while rolling your Swiss roll, the layer will stick on the inside. If you put too much of desiccated coconut all over, it would be difficult for you to roll the Swiss roll. Now set this in your refrigerator for 2 hours. So it's been 2 hours and my Swiss roll is set. I'm going to take it out. You can see the nice aerated, the texture of the cake is so awesome. And it's so light and spongy. And now I'm going to cut the Swiss roll. So just removing the first part or the one which is not even and then cutting the Swiss roll into slices. Look at the beautiful color of the jam and some pieces of desiccated coconut which you can see inside. And here's a closer look, you can clearly see the texture of our beautiful Swiss roll. It tastes amazing. Give this recipe a try and enjoy.